In this video, we will explore the tissue culture process of banana plants, starting from sword suckers and moving through several stages of micropropagation. By the end, you'll understand how to produce disease-free plants ready for cultivation. Let's begin. Extracting the shoot apical meristem. We start with the banana plant sword suckers. From these suckers, we extract the shoot apical meristem. This explant has two main parts. The lower portion, known as the rhizome. The upper portion, known as the pseudostem. By carefully extracting the inner portion of the rhizome and pseudostem, we obtain the inner shoot meristem, which will be used for micropropagation. Preparing the explant. Next, we place the explant in a glass jar. As you may notice, the lower portion turns brown due to the high amount of polyphenol in the banana. To reduce these polyphenol, we treat the explant with a 1% ascorbic acid solution for 2 to 3 minutes. Afterward, we rinse it with sterile RO water 3 times. Sterilizing the explant. To prevent contamination, we follow several sterilization steps. First, treat the explant with tween 25% solution for 2 to 3 minutes. Tween 20 is a detergent that helps clean the explant. Wash the explant again 3 times with sterile water to remove any remaining detergent. Next, treat the explant with 70% ethanol for a few seconds. Rinse again with sterile water to remove any ethanol. Finally, we use a 0.1% mercury chloride solution to further sterilize the explant for 1 minute. Again, wash the explant 3 times with sterile water to ensure no residue remains. Nutrient media for micropropagation. In tissue culture, the nutrient media plays a crucial role in plant growth. There are 3 main types of media used in micropropagation. Initiation media, used to establish the initial growth. Multiplication media, promotes the multiplication of shoots. Rooting media, encourages root development. These nutrient media contain both organic and inorganic salts. Macronutrients like magnesium, potassium, and calcium are added in gram quantities, while micronutrients such as molybdenum and zinc are used in milligram amounts. Additionally, vitamins and other organic additives are included to support plant development. Sterilization of tools and explant. During the process, we sterilize both the plates and forceps to ensure a contamination-free environment. Once sterilized, the 5 to 7 millimeter shoot tips are excised from the rhizomes, trimmed to remove outer coverings, and inoculated into the initiation media. The jar is immediately sealed and labeled with the inoculation date for future reference. Stages of micropropagation. The micropropagation process consists of 4 main stages. Stage 1, collection and inoculation. The shoot apical meristem is inoculated into the nutrient media. This is the initiation stage, where the culture starts its growth journey. Stage 2, multiplication. After 15 to 20 days, the shoot tips are transferred to multiplication media, where they proliferate and multiply due to the presence of growth hormones like auxins and cytokinins. Typically, benzylaminopurine is used for shoot proliferation. Over the course of 3 to 4 subcultures, you can achieve rapid multiplication, eventually producing hundreds of new shoots. Stage 3, root proliferation. Once the shoots are about 5 centimeters tall, they are transferred to rooting media to develop roots. After 24 to 30 days, these plants are ready for further subcultures or transplantation. Stage 4, hardening. The hardened plants are prepared in 2 phases. Primary hardening. Plants are transferred into coco peat trays and kept in polytunnels for 15 to 20 days to acclimatize to normal environmental conditions. Secondary hardening. After 20 days, plants are transplanted into potting mixtures made from 25% FIM, farmyard manure, 25% vermicompost, and 50% soil. These plants are kept in polytunnels for further growth. Ready for the field. After the hardening process, the banana plants are ready for planting in the field. These micropropagated plants are disease-free and available year-round, ensuring a healthy, consistent yield for farmers. By using tissue culture plants, farmers can significantly reduce the risk of plant diseases caused by microorganisms. Conclusion. The micropropagation process is an efficient and highly controlled method of producing banana plants free from disease. By following these precise steps, we ensure that farmers receive healthy, robust plants ready to be grown in the field. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to Discover Agriculture. Share this video with fellow farmers and enthusiasts to help spread knowledge about modern banana cultivation techniques.